Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So today I'm here with the new, it's called the Glow Lust Radiant Luminizer by Auric. And I want to compare it to my Holy Grail Charlotte Tilbury Flawless Filter. Alright, so this was created by Samantha here on YouTube. She's been a YouTuber for a long time. I've been subscribed to her for a long time, like way back when I think it used to be her and another girl. Anyway, she came up with a makeup line. I was so happy to see she added a complexion product. Now, this is the only thing I picked up from her line. I know she has the dual eyeshadows. Anyway, so I wanted to do a comparison, see how they work. So let me just tell you a little bit about the Luminizer. So she has a total of 7 shades, and it's supposed to highlight, smooth, and hydrate. And for those who lust for luminosity, packed with ultra-fine pearl and skin-loving mix of squalane, glycerin, and porcelain flower, this artistry-grade adjustable formula gives you instant radiance and hydration. Hydration is good. I have dry skin. It can be worn alone, blended with your favorite skincare, or used as a highlighter on top of foundation. It's glitter-free, it's fragrance-free, it's paraben-free, it's cruelty-free, and it's gluten-free. Now, this retails for $45. So let's start doing a little bit of the comparison. So this is $45. The Charlotte Tilbury is $44. Charlotte Tilbury has 12 shades, I think 4 of which are mini replicas. So maybe like 8 shades. And she has 7 shades of her formula. Now, when I was looking at her, but I went on online, I think it's called Magic something, her website. When I went online, I really wanted Goldstone, which was described as medium deep with a warm undertone. You guys know I love anything that has a warm undertone. That was sold out. So I settled for Axinite, which is deep neutral. So I figured I can't go wrong with deep neutral. So the packaging is very beautiful. The box fell apart during the shipping because I was going to keep it, but not anymore. Love the green and the gold. Now, well, I might as well just flip the whole box open. This is what it looks like. How stunning is this? Oh my goodness. She did that with her packaging. She didn't scrimp on the packaging. It's very luxurious looking. It looks super, super expensive. Love that it's a glass bottle. Online though, this shade Axinite, which is deep neutral, to me online it looked a lot darker. Doesn't look as dark in person, but let's see. So let's start comparing the two. So this has a total of 35 mils, and this has a total of 30 mils. This I think is a little bit more accessible because you can get it on Sephora. This you have to like go on her website, and a lot of her shades are already sold out, which good for her. Now, as far as packaging, I think it's this is super pretty. I love the gold, the glass bottle. I just love the cover, how this looks. Love the black and gold on this one. And the reason I'm gonna give this the edge, looking at it, it has a pump. It comes with a pump. This has an applicator. So this is less sanitary. You have to go in with the applicator. This comes with a pump, which I thought was super smart. This packaging is, wow. This packaging is really, 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 really pretty. Now these products, because I've been using my Charlotte Tilbury for so long, you guys know I love this as a base for my makeup. This is not, you don't get any coverage with this. This is just to give you that kind of, well, this is Airbrush. It just gives you a flawless base. It gives a little glow. I mostly use it under my makeup. I don't really go over top of it. So what I plan on doing today, because I do not have perfect skin, wish I did. If I had better skin, I would wear it alone. I would. But I don't. So, but instead of like piling a lot of foundation over top of it, because I want to do like a couple hour wear test to see how they both look after, maybe like a couple hours. So I'm just going to use concealer in my T-zone. And I'll put a little bit of like cream bronzer, and then I'll try to like powder it down because I want to see how it looks, you know, I don't want too much makeup like piled on top of it. Anywho, so let's swatch them. I don't have my tray. I'm just going to swatch them. So this is the Charlotte Tilbury. And this, this is shade 7. I also purchased 6.5. I gave it to my niece. It was way too light. I don't know why she jumped to that. So this is the Charlotte Tilbury. And this has like an orangey kind of bronzy color. It works for me because I have a darker skin tone. I like the way it looks under my makeup. I think it gives me like a nice bronzy soft look. But this is kind of orangey, orange red. And let's put the Glow Lust next to it. Oh, the packaging on this. So this is a neutral shade. This is the Glow Lust next to it. The Glow Lust is obviously, I can see some golden in there though, in the Glow Lust, or maybe because it's next to the Flawless Filter, but these are the two side by side. And just swatching it on my hand, the Glow Lust seam, it's a little thicker than the Charlotte Tilbury from just putting it on my hand. All right, so let's go ahead. So I have my Makeup Forever. I've been using it as a color corrector and a grayness corrector. So I have the Makeup Forever on my under eye and a little bit around my chin. Okay, so let's start with a Charlotte on this side. So I usually use my finger, so I'm gonna use my finger for that. And as you can see, yeah, I don't like to put too much around my chin. And we're gonna put some here. And then I like to take my finger and just pat it in and blend it out. I don't like using a brush to do this at all. All right, so this is the Charlotte Tilbury, how it looks on my skin tone. It just gives me that nice kind of bronzy kind of glow. So let's go in with the Glow Lust. Love the name of it, Glow Lust, your lusting glow. Let me get my fingers all clean. Okay. Yeah, this definitely feels more like it has more coverage because that Charlotte Tilbury, like I said, is no coverage, it's just to enhance your skin. All right, now that I put it on my face, it is looking neutral. But when I watched her video, this definitely has some coverage to it. Okay. This has coverage, guys. Wow. I didn't know it had some coverage to it. It's like, I'm trying to hide my armpits. It's like a tinted moisturizer. Oh, it's super. Oh, I like the coverage on this. It's not gonna cover, but there's, I would consider this like a light coverage. Wow. Okay. What I'm noticing right now, initial, the Glow Lust, it's more radiant. Well, like it says, the Charlotte, this frosted bottle, it's a really deceptive. Really doesn't look as dark, but it does look neutral on my skin. The Charlotte has more of a, what's the word? Charlotte is not glittery, because like I said, I've owned this for such a long, it's not glittery, but there's more of a, like a slight metallic, a little bit more metallic, if that's the word I want to use, but it's not glittery or anything. But it's a little bit more like metallic compared to the Glow Lust is just very like, okay, the Glow Lust is more natural. Because with this, you can definitely see like the pops of like the whatever metallic is in it. It's subtle, but you know, I'm comparing the two. And with the Glow Lust and the Glow Lust looks smoother on my face. And it has, I can't get over that it has all this coverage. All right. So that's my observation so far. This is more like in your face, kind of metallic-y. Although there's not a lot of glitter, this is just like a really soft radiance. Like it just looks like I'm wearing amazing skincare or something on my face. All right, so I'm gonna go in with my Hourglass concealer because I don't have great skin. I don't wanna leave my skin like this, but I don't wanna pack foundation on either. So I'm just gonna do the center of my face with the concealer. And this is the Hourglass in the shade Umber. All right, so this is the concealer blended out. I think I have a thing here where I can use the glow lust and just use concealer because this is looking bomb. Well, see me hyping myself up, but it looks bomb to me. Look at the glow lust. You see the Charlotte, I think because the Charlotte is not as, doesn't have that little extra coverage. It just looks like I just illuminated this side, whatever, and I put concealer. This side actually looks as though I'm wearing foundation. Like I have a little bit of coverage. It just looks smooth and glowy and, oh, a dry girl's fantasy come true. So going in with my Fenty powder. I wasn't planning on doing all of this on camera, but why the heck not? Should I go in with the sponge or should I? Oh, I just love the way my skin is looking. Could you imagine like when my skin clear up, which is clearing up already with the shea butter. And I started using African black soap as well. I'm determined to have all this hyperpigmentation go away. All right, so I'm going in with Fenty powder in Honey. Lightly tapping it on first before I go fully in so that none of the product or anything would lift up. I love how everything is looking. And that other shade, I don't know if I'm gonna try it when it's back in stock because I like this neutral shade, this Axinite shade. It's pretty. Oh shoot, I wanted to put a little bit on top. Damn it. Is it too late? I can put a little bit here where I didn't put powder. I wanted to put a little bit of it on top to see if it works over top. All right, let me put a little bit. I'm using the glow lust. Let's put it here because I don't want it touching the powder. I already know how the Charlotte looks over top. Just gonna put a little bit over here. I wish I hadn't powdered. I would have put a little bit more. And let's put some here on her nose. All right. All right. So I did my lower lashes off camera. So let's set it. And like I said, I'm not going to use my beauty sponge. So I'm going in with Hazelnut. I'm going to take a big fluffy brush and just because I just love the way my skin looks. Like, oh, and the black soap does make your skin kind of dry and I'm already dry. So I need all the moisture I can get. So I'm gonna take this big fluffy Japanese brush that I got from TJ Maxx. They be having nice finds in TJ Maxx. And like I said, I'm just gonna, this side though, like, I don't wanna disturb the glow. Oh, it's nice. And I love that I did it with, because I was thinking about what am I gonna use over top of it if I'm gonna do this. Yeah, comparison, because I want most of it peeking through. I figured, you know what? Let me just use concealer and pretend like I have amazing skin. All right. So you see, I'm just getting like the extra, I guess, shine off. And I'm gonna try to wear this for at least 3 to 4 hours today. I think I can do, well, about 3 hours or so, I can. managed to squeeze in. And I'm gonna put a little bit of blush on my cheek. Not a whole lot, just a little bit. And I got the, remember I told you I'm gonna get the other blush palette from Suku, 102. So I got it. I'm gonna put a little bit of this on as well. It'd be nice if I can find my blush. Brush, okay. So I'm taking a little bit of this shade right here. Just putting a little bit on. I'm thinking, should I set it with setting spray? I think I should, because I did put powder. Just a little bit to give the cheek like a little bit of color. Not too much. See how light I'm going? These are pigmented. I've used this once before. I think the shades in the other palette, surprisingly, are to me a little bit more pigmented than this. All right, so just, I'm gonna stop here. And I'm gonna put a little bit of powder highlight. A little bit of my highlighter from my Natasha 10 and bronze palette. I'm putting it on before I set my face this time. Right there, no more than this. And then I'll go back in with the blush brush and just sort of blend everything together, because I want mostly the two illuminators to peek through. All right, let's put some setting spray on, since I did powder it. Okay, I think that's enough. All right, so I finished off with a lip, but this is how everything is looking, and I love this. I think I'm only wearing concealer and powder under this. Like right now though, the glowless side, like I'm wearing a light coverage. The shadow side is popping too. Looks super pretty, but like I said, this is a little bit more natural, has a little bit more coverage. Let's see what time it is. I'm not gonna do a crazy long wear test. It's 10:58 a.m. So like I said, I'm gonna try to do like 3 hours and just see how it looks after 3 hours. Does it get shiny? Does it get too glowy? Like, you know, like what's the story? But right now I feel like my skin looks popping and I love it. All right, guys. So I will see you later. All right, guys, I am back. It's now 6:05 p.m. I was only going to do like 3 or 4 hours, but I got caught up. I put this on around 10:58, so like 11 a.m. Now it's after 6, so it's 7 hours. And this is what they look like, and this is what I have to say. Charlotte, you in danger, girl. This is the bomb. It is gorgeous. Now, let's take a look at the two sides. So, on this side, I have the Glow Lust by Auric. And this side, I have the Charlotte Tilbury. Now, what I would say, though, this side, the Auric side, to me, got shinier than the Charlotte Tilbury. Because I put most of the Auric on my nose, and as you can see, it's a lit. It is shiny. But this is so beautiful because, like I said, it has some coverage and it looks like a tinted moisturizer. It looks so pretty. And although it got shinier, it's still not as, what's the word? Kind of like metallic-y, sort of like the Charlotte Tilbury. Still love the Charlotte Tilbury, but girl, that one over there, it's fire. It's beautiful. I can see myself just putting this on now with just concealer. It is popping. It's beautiful. There's a natural soft radiance to it. Although to me, like I said, it's been 7 hours. It definitely got a little shinier, because if you look here, see, and then compare to here, this side is definitely shinier. And along this area here is shinier than over here where the Charlotte Tilbury is. The Charlotte Tilbury, to me, especially how I use it, I mostly put it on my cheekbones and I'll blend some of it out. I don't go all the way up here with it. I'll put some of the center in here. With the Auric, with the Glow Lust, I can see myself taking my hands, and I love using it with my hands. I don't intend to use it with a brush. I can see myself like going all around my face with it as a base, and then maybe going in with like the La Mer Tinted Moisturizer or something like that. Let me raise my ring light up a little bit so you guys can, because it's dark in this room. All right. So, because I want you guys to have a good look. Charlotte Tilbury. The coverage is not there because it's just supposed to be like a film, like a filter on your skin, as you guys can see. And when you look at the side, the Glow Lust side, you can see a little bit of coverage. Like you can see it's a very light coverage. Looks very smooth and just, this is beautiful. She did a fantastic job. This is her first launch. It's fantastic. So, like I said, Charlotte is in danger, girl. Because this is coming for her neck. It is. It's coming for her neck. It's the bomb, the packaging. It has 5 more mils. This has 30. This is a dollar more. The advantage with the Charlotte Tilbury, this is more accessible. You can walk into Sephora, you can swatch it, and you can pick it up. This you still have to purchase online. Who knows? Maybe one day her brand will be in Sephora. Did you guys see that Nessa Myers is going to be in Sephora? I'm so happy for her. I'm so happy for her. And the packaging. I still give Charlotte the edge because her glass bottle is not frosted. I'm not a huge fan of frosted bottles just because, you know, to me you don't see the true color. But this is, I mean, and this is by a hair. This is nitpicking, okay? Because both of them are just very luxe, very beautiful. But, okay. My final thought. I'm giving the Glow Lust an edge. And you know this is my holy grail item. This is like my favorite thing from Charlotte Tilbury. Oh my God, this is so good. And this neutral color I think worked out perfect for me. I don't really miss the golden undertone because to me it just looks... There's a little gold in it. I think it looks very pretty, this neutral Axinite shade. Absolutely love it. So I totally recommend this, guys, picking it up. A lot of the shades are sold out on her website, though. But this is thebomb.com. All right, guys. I want to thank you so much for watching this video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I love this side of my skin. And I love using it with the concealer. Anywho, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. And I'll see you in my next one. Bye, guys.